Welcome to Hereford Cathedral and to this Easter Monday organ concert, which we're putting online for the first time. I'm going to be playing a wide range of music that shows off some of the wonderful colours and the strength of this fantastic Father Willis organ we have here in the cathedral. Cesato's Mohrentanz seems to use the full resources of the organ, but I think the next piece uses even more. People often ask me, why do we have to have four keyboards on the organ? And of course it's true that most organs don't have four manuals, they might just have one or two or three. We're very lucky here at the cathedral because we have four keyboards and of course a separate pedal department as well. And basically it enables you to play lots of different volumes of sound, different qualities of sound at the same time or in quick succession. And so you can have quick contrasts, and that's something that this piece shows off very well. This is William Walton's Coronation March, Orb and Sceptre. It's one of those pieces that's tremendously exciting. It's a great swashbuckling march that's then followed by a very grand and majestic tune. The grand and majestic tune then returns in triumph in the home key as you get towards the end. And there always seems to be some more sound that you can add to the Hereford organ, and this is very much the case in this march, composed by William Walton in 1953 for the coronation of Her Majesty the Queen. Thank you.
Hereford Cathedral, we're very lucky because the building is surrounded by some beautiful gardens, and there are some wonderful teams of gardeners who look after these lovely gardens. I'm out here in the Chapter House yard, surrounded by some spring blooms, which is rather nice. It feels as if it's been a very long winter with the lockdown and the isolation, and the signs of spring are particularly welcome this year. The next piece I'm going to play is an audible version of some of those signs of spring. It's Grieg's famous piece, Morning, from Peer Gynt. It's a piece I knew very well as a child because it was played on our record player at home quite a lot. And it's lovely to play the transcription by Edwin Lemaire of this wonderful orchestral work. You can hear all the woodwind pretending to be the birdsong and the rushing of the waters. And if you listen very carefully, you may even hear Hereford Cathedral organ's famous Glockenspiel stop. Thank you.
I'm standing here at the high altar in the choir of Hereford Cathedral, in front of two of the panels from the reredos that depict the events of Easter morning, the resurrection of Jesus. I'm here because I'm going to play now three short pieces based on hymns for Easter Day. First of them is by the Australian organist, George Thornton Ball, who worked for most of his life at the Temple Church in central London. This is a very short setting of this joyful Eastertide, given the title Vruchten, the Dutch word. Then I'm going to play a piece by Dame Ethel Smythe, a setting of a German chorale, Erschienen ist der Heiligtag, the joyful day has arrived. And this is a setting that reflects her scholarship in the city of Leipzig when she was studying in Germany, studying, amongst others, the music of J.S. Bach. And Bach, of course, is the composer of the third of this little triptych of pieces I'm going to play. The final piece is Chrislag in Todesbanden, Bach's very majestic setting, depicting something of the strength of the resurrection. Just by the side of the Lady Chapel at Hereford Cathedral is this rather small and beautiful orderly chapel. You might not even notice it if you came to visit the cathedral, but it's worth coming to see, if only for the wonderful windows around it, stained glass windows by Tom Denny that he created in 2007. These windows celebrate the work and life of Thomas Traherne, the 17th century Herefordshire poet and clergyman. Traherne was somebody who really appreciated and valued the natural world around him, and this is reflected in the glass here, because if you choose to look in detail, you can find all sorts of insects and birds and animals and details of plants that represent the joys that Traherne found in the natural world around him. The piece I'm going to play now, which is Handel's organ concerto, also celebrates the natural world around us. It's the cuckoo and the nightingale, because the sound of the organ solo line represents, in fact, some of the birdsong that you might hear on a spring day. It's one of the movements of Handel's organ concerto, and it's arranged by Marcel Dupré. And so, in a way, a little bit like these windows, it's like a 20th century take, or a modern take, on an older original. So this is the second movement of Handel's organ concerto, The Cuckoo and the Nightingale. Anniversaries are always a good excuse to discover some new music. Marcel Dupre, who arranged that Handel organ concerto I've just played, died in fact 50 years ago this year in 1971, and so it's good to hear some of his work. The composer of the next piece I'm going to play, Camille Saint-Saëns, died 100 years ago in 1921. Saint-Saëns is probably best known for his works The Carnival of the Animals, The Great Organ Symphony, and perhaps Danse Macabre, but here is an actual piece he wrote for solo organ. This is his first fantaisie, his first fantasy, and it's a really quite original piece in the way that it uses the different manuals of the organ, written for a three-manual instrument, but it uses chords in quick succession, the same chord on different keyboards, creating a nice echo effect in the first section of this fantaisie. This is then followed by a very exciting and grand march. Saint-Saëns' Fantaisie in E-flat. We're now coming towards the end of today's concert, and I've come to the 32-foot bombard pipes in the south choir aisle here at Hereford Cathedral, because these are perhaps the loudest and greatest pipes of all the organ. These have produced a really big bass sound that you hear at in the sweeping tune that underpins Vidal's famous toccata, and that's the piece with which I'm going to finish today's concert, the fifth movement of his fifth organ symphony. But before then, I'm going to play two short pieces. First of all, the chorale prelude on Dominus Regit Mei by Christopher Durnley, a one-time organist of St. Paul's Cathedral. This is a very relaxed and quiet piece, setting the well-known hymn which paraphrases Psalm 23, a paraphrase written by Henry Williams Baker, who was born 200 years ago this year, in 1821, and he was rector of, or vicar, I think, of Monkland, and basically compiled the first commonly used hymn book in this country. Hymns ancient and modern. After Dominus Regit Mei by Christopher Durnley, I'm going to play a beautiful but rather sort of sad chorale prelude by Brahms, Herzlich tut mich verlangen. This is based on the Passion Chorale, and of course reminds us that before you get to Easter, you have to go through the whole Passion story. And then after that, the very loud and strong Vidal toccata at the end. that's the end of today's recital. I hope you've very much enjoyed at least some of it anyway. And if you feel like supporting our work here, please do consider making a donation. I think the links will be shown at the end of this video. Also keep an eye on the Cathedral's website, because we're hoping that we'll be able to put up some organ concerts during the course of the summer, depending of course on how things develop. Have a very happy Easter and a good summer beyond that.